Welcome to installment number 326 of the mitzvahs as enumerated by Maimonides, the Rambam. Today we have one commandment, negative commandment number 287, which is the prohibition for a relative to testify for or against their relative in a Jewish court of law. And as we said, this doesn't matter if it was for or if it was against. And so this is very interesting because there are other types of relationships that are allowed. For example, somebody who hates his neighbor or his friend or whoever it is allowed to testify against him or for him in court. Somebody who is deeply in love with another person is also allowed to, is qualified to testify for them in a court of law. So why is it specifically relatives? So firstly, we are told this is just one of those mitzvahs that are just very hard to understand. But a beautiful explanation, or a more logical explanation, I should say, that is given is that in those days, and even today, it's very common for families to live in close proximity to each other. And what happens is that when you live very close to somebody and you spend a lot of time together, it's inevitable that there are going to be disagreements and that things are going to come up and that someone is going to want to take somebody else to court and it's going to be a little bit messy, a little bit ugly. And so therefore, in order to preempt this, in order to avoid this type of situation, it is off the cuff said relatives cannot take each other, cannot testify against each other in a court of law. And this way, it just kind of eliminates this potential issue that would arise. Now the Tzemach Tzedek, the third Chabad Rebbe, gives a beautiful explanation to this as well. And he says, you know, we know, how do we know that it is true that the Torah was given to us on Mount Sinai? Because of the testimony, right? Given by who? By our forefathers. So wait a minute. How can we trust the testimony given by our forefathers if they are our relatives? Then that should disqualify. And then he says, well, this is the truth. However, it wasn't just our forefathers that witnessed it. It was 600,000 men between the ages of 20 and 60 that witnessed it. How much more so the women, the children, those that were above the age of 60, those that were below the age of 20, how much more so, how many millions of people witnessed it? And here we're talking about, a momentous occasion, a momentous event that was seen by millions of people, and all of them passed on to their children and children's children and for all generations, this incredible event that took place. Unlike other religions who only a small group of people were privy to seeing the prophet or whatever, you know, momentous thing that their religion is based off of, here it was actually in front of millions of people, and it is their testimony that we have that brings us to this day, that we know that not just the written Torah but the oral Torah was all given on Mount Sinai on that day, not just from our forefathers but from many, many others as well. Have a wonderful day.